going on YouTube? Moose78 back at you with some more American Truck Simulator. This, of course, is my Let's Play series, Stories from the Road. We are in episode number 15 today. Hope you're all doing well, by the way. We are heading out of Phoenix, going up to Flagstaff with a load of frozen fruits. This is a contracted run. That, of course, is one of the new features in the 1.3 open beta, which, of course, we are running since we are in Arizona. And I don't know if it's something that they've changed since the update went live about a week ago, but notice the speed limit is only 55 for trucks now. And that could be a condition of this contract, though, too. Set the cruise control there. That's one of the cool things I think about the contracts, is certain ones have your speed limited. Like some of the ones I had been running, my top speed was limited to 70 mile an hour, even though the speed limit was, say, 75. So just kind of a cool feature. But overall, I am absolutely loving this expansion. I think this is what the game should have been from launch. And you can definitely tell they've taken their time and did a pretty good job on this. And that road system, the interstate system, is pretty solid now. Much better than the first two states, by far, in my opinion, anyway. Over here so this guy can get on. That is one thing that still needs some lovin's, is the merge lanes. The on-ramps are pretty solid now. I'm really liking those. Most of those are pretty good on the interstates in Arizona, anyway. But the merge lanes need some lovin's. Still pretty much the suicide merge lanes, as some people call them. But yeah, loving the scenery. They have a lot of actual landmarks. The roads aren't as plain and as flat as they are in the first two states, and you have a lot of turns and curves like this that are kind of banked. So you can really feel the physics in the truck a lot more than you can in the vanilla version of the game. And I've actually disabled, I had a physics mod and I actually disabled that, and I'm kind of liking this a little bit better than the mod. But I'm really digging the World of Trucks external contracts, how it keeps progress of that on your World of Trucks page. And I will link my profile page down in the description. I'll also link my album over on Picture Push of all the screenshots I take in-game. I don't take a lot of them when I'm recording, but when I'm just doing some, just playing the game, no recording or anything like that, I tend to take quite a few screenshots. So check that album out to check some of those screenshots out. Thought you guys might enjoy that. And that just feels, this just feels cool. I just love all these overpasses, how the roads intersect and all that. Good job by SES. I know a lot of us like to give them some grief for this, that, and a little bit of everything, but I am definitely excited about what the future holds for this game if all the map expansions are as good as this one. By far the best thing I've played from SCS, period. Holland, PTTM, Cross America. And another thing that could use a little bit of loving is... my driving skills, for one thing. There we go. But I wish they had some kind of advance notice for when the speed limit's gonna change like that. And you see we went from like a 55, a 65 mile an hour zone right down to 25. Boom. So that makes for some pretty hairy situations. But I wish one thing they could do with that is, you know how when you're coming up on a way station, how you get that advance notice just a little bit before you get to the way station. Wish they could do something like that with the speed limit change. Hey, in 1 mile, whatever it is. But it just gives you some kind of notice, hey, there's a speed limit change, you might want to slow down. I think that would be pretty amazing. Closing in on our destination here. And one thing I really liked about this update is it did not affect a lot of my mods, which is always nice. Like all my sound mods working just fine. So that's a plus. And if you guys are interested, all my mods are linked down in the video description. So be sure to check that out. If you see something you like, it should be in the video description, with the exception of my Collada mods. Those will not, of course, be up for download since it is a private VTC. And it's not my VTC, it's just one that I am a part of. Been a part of that for, gosh, probably 5-6 years now. Let's see, I am feeling like a pansy, so we are just going to play it safe. Right over there, I can do that. Block these people in after I drop my trailer over here. Get this thing drop, grab another contract, and get it going. I thought we were in the spot. Now, can I not pick the trailer back up? Or I have to recouple to it? Interesting. It's got to be pretty much, yeah. There we go. Whoops. Well, the thing came up a second ago for me to drop this. Now it's like, nah. There we go. There we go. I can even make the easiest things challenging, kids. That's my superpower. That's my superpower. We shall continue on here. All right, let's check the external contracts coming out of Flagstaff. See what kind of trouble we can get ourselves into now. Grand Canyon Village. That's pretty cool. If you've not been there, definitely check that out. Holbrook. I don't think I've been there yet. Maybe I have. Kingman. I know I've not been to Kingman yet. Need to run over to Kingman. See what other trailers we got going over to Kingman, if any. Ehrenberg. I've not been there yet. Might take another reefer and head down to Ehrenberg. Reefer. And if you guys have not noticed, love pulling the reefer trailers. Someday when we have trailer ownership, I'm gonna have me one of them there reefer trailers. Good times to be had by all. At least me, anyway. This is like stuff going up into California. To Elko. That'd be a good run. We might do that next episode. Take a run from, like, if we go down here to Ehrenberg, run up back into Nevada for a nice long haul, then loop back into Arizona. Did that the other day. Took a load. I think it was down around either Phoenix or Tucson, ran up to Ely, Nevada, and man, that was a nice, nice run. Took about a good, probably 40, 45 minutes, maybe just a little bit longer than that, but man, those are definitely the runs I'm looking at getting into. Let's grab this and head down to Ehrenberg. Oh, I was going to crash there for a second. I was getting screwed. Right. Yeah, the scenery in this map is freaking amazing, in my opinion. Like, especially you get up around the northwest corner of Arizona, up around the Hoover Dam. My gosh, does that just look good. The mountains and everything up through there, and it looks amazing. Where is our load? I love how it seems like there's more distribution centers like this in the game now too. So that's pretty cool. Liking that. Around the front here? Or even at the right place? Nope, I'm not even at the right place. We need to run down the street to sell goods. Not a problem. See anything coming? Peterbilt dealer. All your Peterbilt needs. Here we are. is our trailer. See if we can't get this one bang on first time. I do have the advanced trailer coupling feature turned on, as you guys saw back there. I'm liking it so far. Really liking it. Again, I think it's more of a fix than a feature. Just my opinion. But I'm liking it nonetheless. We are not even going to be close. Now, without that feature turned on, I could probably hook up to the trailer right there, no problem. But that's not really realistic. And you gotta be pretty much dead nuts on to be able to hook this thing up. And ideally, you want to kind of be right in the middle of the two white lines, the one there on this side, and you see the one there on the passenger side. You do that, then you're pretty much golden. Must be over a little bit too much. Yeah, you can see I'm kind of just off just a little bit. I'm not that far off. There we go. Yeah, I don't think I was that far off. And it could be because I'm using a modded trailer that the coupling feature is a little bit wonky. I did go back and add it. All it is just some collision boxes that they added. So I went and took those off of the updated 579 and added it to my 579 in a Z-Mod. But it could be because I'm using a trailer mod. It could be a little bit wonky. So I'll have to take a look at some of the SES trailers and see if there's anything that needs updating there as well. All right, we've got our frozen fruits. We're going down Ehrenberg. Get after it. It's the same way. It's like 30,000. Pull it out kind of hard there. Kind of look around and just look, that's an awesome shot right there. Just looking back at those mountains, the trees. I don't know how accurate this is to Arizona and the territory. I've never been to the Southwest. I've been fortunate enough to get up to the Pacific Northwest many, many years ago, but I've never been down to the Southwest. I don't know how accurate it is, but I do like the game world and environment that they have created with the Arizona expansion. I don't know if it's a placebo effect. I know I've probably said that about a dozen times now. I don't know if it's a placebo effect, or if it's just, you know, because I've been waiting to play this for so long, or if they've actually done this good of a job, but man, I am enjoying it. I have been playing a lot of ATS lately. I mean, I've been playing that over the Division, over Overwatch. So yeah, it's been very, very satisfying for me personally, and hopefully for you as well. Still gotta adjust that brake sensitivity just a skosh. It must be just a little slight incline on this. Keep drifting back. Definitely looking forward to getting the SKRS shifter knob in. That's going to be a lot of fun. Can't remember if I talked about it already, but I'm still using paddles on the side of the G27 wheel, the brake handles or whatever, for my high-low range of my splitter, and it gets a little bit cumbersome from time to time. Out here on the interstate and get the trailer trucking. Yeah, everything just looks so good in this expansion. Really excited to see what they have in store for us next. If they're going to keep going east, if they're going to go down to the southwest a little bit more, maybe Texas, maybe head back up into the northwest and get us Oregon or something like that. I would definitely be okay with Oregon. Be pretty cool to take some runs from Oregon down to Arizona. But for me personally, this expansion was definitely worth the wait. Can't wait to see what the final product looks like. I know they've been fixing a lot of the bugs that have been reported. A link for that forum over the SES forum will be down below, as well as a link on how they want the bugs reported. If you guys don't already know how to do that, there'll be a link in the description that just gives you a brief tutorial on how to post the information. I know I was using that the other day. And one of the beta testers pretty much was right there on the spot to kind of help me out. So much, much appreciated there. Whoops. Yeah, they must have changed the speed limit because before, I think when I was playing yesterday, I was able to do like 75. Out on the interstate. But again, I don't know if it's one of the contracts limit my speed to 55 or what, but it's all good. No worries. We get everything dialed in on the sim. Playing a lot more lately, so I've been kind of messing around with some things, and I think I pretty much got everything set up the way I want to. Recently changed the wheel settings on the G27. I think I originally had it at like 500 degrees of rotation. I went ahead and changed all the way up to 900 now, so it's a lot more realistic. Oh man, just look at the sky. That's pretty awesome. There we go. Yeah. Safely exited the interstate. Been working on that. Don't need any mishaps like we had a couple episodes back there. I think it was last episode, actually. That was a nightmare. Also, the playlist link is down in the video description. You guys want to check out the playlist for Season 1 and now Season 2. And the reason why I'm calling them Season 1 and Season 2, it's just breaking up the playlist into a little bit more manageable segments. Instead of having like 100 videos in a playlist, I'm just keeping them limited to about a dozen. Light. Thank you. I just like a lot of the new assets they have in this map. Little strip malls like that. Some of the houses. Again, some of the new companies to deliver to. I've not been to Phoenix Freight yet, so I'm kind of keeping a lookout for something going over to Phoenix Freight. Nah, just go ahead, dude. It's cool. But if anyone has any information or knows for sure if they did change the map scale or not, leave a comment down below. Kind of interested. Almost seems like they did. And like, I don't know how all that works, if they can change the scale just on one part of the map and not affect the other two. I don't know, but I'm really liking... There we go. And I'll be so glad when the SKRS gets in. And I'm not slapping these pedals on the side of the wheel to getting a high, low, and all that stuff. But it just seems like the runs are taking a little bit longer. You know, it's staying daylight a little bit longer, it seems like. You know, I had a mod and it didn't change the scale of the map, but it changed the time to 119, which is the scale for ETS2. I didn't see the sign, I just wonder if this is the RFS. Not sure where the Pat Tillman Memorial Bridge is. I don't know if that's it. That might just be a bridge there. That might be the one going across the Hoover. Seven, we're good there. Closing in on 6 miles a gallon. Kind of happy about that. But I had a mod in that changed the time to 119, so that way it stayed daylight quite a bit longer, and of course, you know, stayed darker longer, just slowed down the time of the game. And I've not noticed too much of a difference after I took that mod out, because it was causing a conflict. Oh, that's what I was able to determine there the other day when I was having some crashing issues. I think it was down around Santa Cruz, which it was kind of weird that it was crashing around Santa Cruz and not anywhere else. But I think it had to do with the fact that it was the time of the game. It was going from like dusk to night. Coming up on Ehrenberg, we can see there on the mini. There we go, 6 miles to the gallon, baby. That'll make the boss man happy. If they could make some of these exit ramps just a little bit longer too, I think that would be kind of beneficial. Go, dude. Go. 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 Thank you. Thank you, driver. Should just be right up here. Where is it going to? What? Yeah, we are just going to go ahead and skip that altogether because, well, eh, give it a shot. These little Wahlberts are about a pain to get a round in. And once again, time to activate my superpowers and take this simple little task and just convolute the straight hell on out of it. Like a boss. Let me do what I want to do here. It's going to tell me to go fly a kite. One thing I want to do to the G27 is I want to swap out the springs on the accelerator and the clutch. That way the clutch is nice and soft, and the accelerator is just a little bit more stiff. Probably do that here over the next couple days. Watch one of them there fancy YouTube tutorials and think I can handle that. The animal. Let me do it. I don't believe so. Well, so, what I'm gonna do since the woolworts like this are extremely cramped. Let's hope there's anything. If there is, they'll stop. Oh, damn, damn! Look both ways, kids. Go, come on! Look. Jesus! Just coming out everywhere! Ah! Let's see. I am probably just going down a deep, deep rabbit hole that I don't need to go down here, but I'm gonna go back, see if I can't get turned around in the charged parking lot, and then I think I can do it. Just like I thought I could pull in over at Walbert with no issues. Just like I thought I could cross the road with no issues. Oh yeah, there we go. I did it, yay! I did good. Freaking barely. ...550 horsepower motor. There we go. Can't get the wheels over the curb. GG, Moose. GG. G to the G. G. Get all backered out, straighten it out here, and be good to go. Should be good. Cross the road before I go anywhere and get some gas, some fuel. There we go. Alright guys, that's going to wrap it up for episode 15. Hopefully you enjoyed it. If so, please give it a like and share. This helps me out a bunch, helps the channel grow. If you're new to the channel and are not already subscribed, please consider doing so now. Be sure to tune in next Tuesday for episode 16, A Stories from the Road. Be sure to come back on Wednesday for some more gameplay footage. I am going to start getting some Arizona open beta gameplay footage up on the channel. Then, of course, we're back on Thursday with more American Truck Sim Stories from the Road. Guys, thanks for watching and hanging out. I greatly appreciate your support. Until the next one, guys, take care. We'll be seeing ya. Hey, guys, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed this video. please take a moment and subscribe to my channel. Also, if you want to follow me over on the Twitters, click on the link in the description. And if you're looking for great gaming gear at an affordable price, click my NoScope affiliate link also down in the description. And if you want more ATS content, click on the video to check out my Stories from the Road playlist. Thanks, and we'll catch you in the next one.